Hello and welcome back. My name is Afzal and you're watching channel Code X. Today in this tutorial, we'll see how can we achieve a dark theme and a light theme in Flutter application at runtime. Here's a preview of my real-time application called VidStatus. I think it's VidInfo. Yeah. So without wasting much time, let's jump into the code and we'll create a new project. Okay, our basic application is up and running. Now we'll play with the brightness parameter. So all we have to do is change the brightness of our theme data to our desired brightness, say for example light or dark, and the Flutter changes entire application theme. It's that easy with Flutter. The only challenge is how can we change this value at runtime on click of a button or switch, something like that. So for that we need to repaint this material app. We need to create this material app again on a click of button or changing the switch, because it's entirely new theme. So for that we'll create another class, stateful class, theme builder, and we'll pass a function as a parameter to this class. This function will return us another material app, so it will override our previous material app and it will give us a new change theme material app. All right, so we'll pass their builder function, okay, and we'll wrap this material app with the theme builder. This takes builder as a parameter. Perfect. So because we have not provided any theme yet, any brightness yet, so our application is full dark. Now we'll initialize the brightness inside a init method of state. For now let's make it the brightness of light, so it's a light theme by default. And when I return this widget.builder, it will become a light theme application. Perfect. Now how can we change it? So to change the theme, we'll write a method and we'll access it from our main class. The simple logic: if the brightness is dark, we'll make it light. If it's light, we'll make it dark. Now we have to access from our main.dart, that is our home page. And yeah, don't forget to set the state of application so that it changes, the brightness changes are reflected. So let's go to our main page, home page, and call this method from increment function or whatever function you want to call from. To access this object, we need a static object to access the theme data. So we'll create a static method called of, which will return an object from the state, okay, and it does it using a type matcher. And now we have access to this object, so let's call change theme. Now when I click on this button, it should change to black. Yep, it's working good. Now let's run the application, and you can see that the application is by default running in a light theme because we have initialized the value with the light. Now we need a default parameter. So in our theme builder, we'll write one more variable, and we'll get this variable from our calling function. So let's set our default theme as dark. Okay, now when we launch the application, our application will launch in dark theme by default. That was a splash screen for white, so forget it, you can change the splash screen. All right, so all set. Now let's quickly set up a second page so that I can demonstrate that this theme changing is working for entire application and not just a single page. So I'll quickly write another page and call on the button click. So here you can see whenever I click the button, it's going to the next page and the theme is applied to all the application. Okay, one last thing is pending, that is getting the current state of brightness. So for that we'll write a method, getCurrentState or getCurrentBrightness, something like that. All right, which will return the brightness. This information is useful when you are handling with a switch or something, so that you can change the value of switch depending on the current state. Alright, so it's very easy, very simple. You just have to wrap this material theme inside a theme builder, provide a builder, that's it. And if you don't want to do all these things, you can do easily with plugin. That is a Dart package. You can use dynamic theme. It has a very good rating, 98, and it works very well. So if you want to develop for yourself, you can develop it, or if you want to achieve it quickly, you can use a package. It all depends on your choice. That's it for this video. Stay tuned. I'll be creating more Flutter tutorials like this. Subscribe if you haven't and do like this video. Put your comments and suggestions in the comment box below. Thank you for watching. See you next time.